So what happens when you want to eat well? It's hard, isn't it? You go out to different places and you think, I'm really a raw eater. I like to have my food mostly alkaline. So we're going to do a little bit of a challenge here today. In fact, we're at a cafe called the Little Green Cafe. They don't know that we're coming. And what we're going to do is give them the food test. We're going to get them to prepare two meals. They don't know that, so I'm whispering. Two meals in 15 minutes that are really totally raw. So just follow me around here and we're going to go into the Little Green Cafe and surprise the owner and find out if in 15 minutes he could produce two totally raw meals, and they've got to pass the test. Follow me.
Hey guys, you still open?
Yeah.
You are? Okay. My name's Samantha Bachman. I'm from a program called My Rawgasms, and we've just dropped in as a surprise to see if you can do the food challenge. You up to it?
Alright,
how's that? It's easy, wasn't it? Straight into it. Alright, can I come around now?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's your name?
Simon.
Okay, Simon, I'm Samantha Bachman. Pleased to meet you. So we've got a little bit of a challenge for you. I can see you're at the end of the day, so you're not too busy. We've got a couple of customers over there. The idea is you've got 15 minutes to produce two meals, and they need to be all raw. We've got no sugar, no butter, no flour, no grains whatsoever. So if I came in and said to you, look, I'm really looking after my health and my diet, and I don't want to have foods that are not only raw and full of nutrition, but alkaline. In other words, we're going from that too. You can either do an entree, a main course, or a soup, or a dessert. So I'm going to leave it to you. In fact, do you mind if we film while we're doing this?
No, that's all right.
Okay, so you've got 15 minutes from now. From now. Getting into it, so this is going to be interesting. We're going to follow Simon and see what he comes up with. He's actually pretty calm right now. Hang on, we'll see the chaos in just a second. Okay, he's looking.
So, can I use nuts?
You can use nuts.
Just having a look at what I've got.
Okay, you can't use flour, you can't use any grains, so to speak, and you can't use sugar. So we're really having, we can use good oils, so it's got to be, we're not looking at low in calorie, we're looking at low in sugars. So natural sugars is good, like honey or fruit sugars. Okay, we've started with the bowl, that's a good start.
I've got some
agave.
Syrup.
Now this is good. This man's prepared, he's got agave nectar, which is a cactus sweetener, by the way.
Almond meal,
yes, that'll work.
Can I use coconut?
You can use coconut. So he obviously has a plan at this point. We've got almond meal, we've got coconut, and we've got agave. Now, of course, the coconut is great because it's good to send all the natural fats in it, natural fatty acids. Almond meal, also great natural fats, both high in fibre. And agave cactus sweetener, which is, you know, way, way better than sugar, of course.
Alright, so I've just pulled off with some orange.
You've got an orange. Okay,
some craisins.
Craisins. Crazy flour. About craisins.
And I've just got some psyllium.
Okay, this is, so what's the plan? You don't know, you're just going to throw it together and see what it comes up like.
Yeah.
Is there a method in what you, because obviously you've grabbed some things.
I mean, if it's all going to be raw, can't really cook it to thicken it up, so.
Yeah.
You're going to have to use the psyllium husk to.
Yeah, so you've obviously done something like this before just to have an idea. Yeah.
In past restaurants.
Yes.
Can't use flour, so I'm going to use the almond flour.
And is this based on a dish that would have normally been cooked?
No.
Okay.
No, this one. I've had a few ideas from other areas where using corn flour and all that, but you have to cook it out. So.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
This one here, sort of just let it set.
Yeah,
turn
so this
out.
Is like your invention?
Yeah.
Cool, okay. We've got Simon's whatever it's going to be, but it's certainly got oranges, coconut, and almond meal in it. Okay, so this is dish one. Is this a sweet?
It's sweet. It's very zesty.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I suppose you could have it as a dessert. You could even have it as a breakfast.
Okay.
If you wanted it. So I'm just going to... segment this orange up.
Okay, so just explain to the viewer as you're going what your plan is.
Alright, so just peeling the orange.
Your staff are pretty calm considering we've just wandered in. In fact,
I think they're shy. Yeah, I think they're shy.
They've completely disappeared.
Over here.
So I'm just going to cut this up into smaller pieces so it's not so bulky.
So you're using the psyllium as a binder and a thickener and to hold it together.
Yeah, it'll...
Which is good thinking.
Can't use too much of it though. So.
Yeah, with the psyllium, it's a great fibre. It's really got no calories in it or kilojoules. So it's great to bind stuff together. A lot of people use it in those drinks, like the fibre drinks, to make sure that the bowels work. One thing about that though, with some people that have chronic constipation, psyllium will actually make them worse. Because psyllium's such a, it absorbs, it's like a sponge, it absorbs all the water that's in the, that's, you know, going through the gastrointestinal tract. So unless you have extra water, what happens is it just becomes this hard lump and it's just as hard to get out. So if you're going to have something like that, you must have extra water to make sure that it goes through, and light on the psyllium, otherwise it will actually bind you. So people think that it's, you know, helps with, you know, moving stuff through the colon. It actually can make it worse. Seems these guys are pretty calm considering 5 minutes has already gone by. We are on the dessert, but we haven't even started on the main course yet. Sounds like it's going to be a chickpea salad to me. I'd run if I was you, girl. Go to the fast checkout. Just as well as the supermarket handy. So the thing is, really, if we're going to go into a restaurant and we want to do the all raw just about thing, I think it actually would pay to ring ahead and let them know that you're coming, you're on a special, not a special diet, but you're on a really healthy way of eating, and that you're going to be wanting something that's not cooked, but you want to spoil your taste buds as well. Because otherwise they're going to say, no, we haven't got the stuff in stock. So if you ring ahead and just say, look, you know, these are the rules. I don't eat flour, I don't eat sugar, I don't eat butter, or whatever it is else you don't eat, and give the chef at least 24 hours notice to actually prepare something for you. Well, how easy is this? Been just on just over 5 minutes, and we've got a dessert.
We've got almond meal.
Yeah.
Psyllium husk.
Yeah.
To thicken it up. Coconut, just to give it a nicer, sort of a milkier flavour.
Yeah.
A dark agave syrup.
Yeah.
To sweeten it up. Orange juice, just to give it some moisture.
Yeah.
Pieces of orange. You can also put orange zest through it.
Yeah.
Maybe even a little bit of mint.
So looking at that, we could not only do it as a dessert or a pie, a cake, something like that. Just looking at this, I would try doing something like this, using it as a base and putting perhaps a jelly-y type topping on it, using, gelatine, but using agar-agar. But this could almost, I'm just going to have a fiddle with this, guys, this could almost do as little balls as well. See, I'm playing with the mixture to see how it comes together.
Do you want to rock it in here?
Yeah.
No, half.
Okay, there you are. We could turn into balls. It holds together very well. So now for the taste test on it. The strongest flavour is the coconut. The coconut and the almond. So you can't taste the psyllium at all because it's got no taste in it, of course. So I think this is going to work. Excuse me, sir. What's your name? Andrew, are you staying around a minute? We're going to get him to do a taste test. Just stick around. We're going to give you some spoil your taste buds. Cool. What's going on? That's right. We've got rocket, we've got carrot, we've got zucchini, chickpeas, and sweet corn. Geez, I tell you, your lady was quick. She must have stole it. She didn't have time to go out for a checkout. Did you tell them I'll pay you later?
Yeah, I did. I have an IOU.
I need to do it. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so zucchini. This is all low in sugars, which is absolutely excellent. Zucchini's quite alkaline. Your rocket. Okay, we're putting all that together. And that's a main course salad. It's not, most people give you lettuce, tomato, and cucumber and call that a salad. This is really going to fill the spot. We might suffer a bit of flatulence. Wow, look at that. Okay, you've got 30 seconds left.
You're giving me a small plate.
Yep.
Come on, girlfriend. Okay, we're getting down. We're just a bit to go. Look at that dessert. How cool is that?
Some fresh crayons on top.
Wow.
No.
What do you want? Do you want to dish it up with anything? We are down to...
No. I've only got chantilly cream and that's illegal.
20 seconds. Okay. How's that? In 15 minutes, he made not only a raw dessert and a mostly raw main course. It's all high in fibre. So here we've got Simon's special, we'll call this. We'll call it an orange coconut almond cake, which is obviously staying together. Oh, look at that. Wow. See, now there's no flour in that and it wasn't baked. With that, with the chickpeas, great. The only thing different I would have done is use raw corn. Just shave it off there because raw corn is far better to digest than what it is in the tin. But we did surprise him. The chickpeas and the beans out of the tin is acceptable because, you know, it's a bit hard to sort of, we either got to cook them ahead or have them raw. And if we have them raw, they'd need to be sprouted. So the only thing was the corn. But apart from that, I think he wins hands up.
That's good.
Yeah? Would that satisfy you?
I think so.
Yeah? All right, let's try. Because of all the beans in there and the fibre.
What's in it?
That surprised me. It's nicer than I thought.
Yeah.
What's in, it's the dressing. It's
It's a balsamic reduction. So it's, I suppose you could say it's illegal in a way.
Well, if we do 80% really good, and the other bit we allow, it's actually surprising.
It's vinegar and sugar reduced down to almost make a syrup, so to speak. So,
just perfect. So, I think I'm spitting bits across there. What happened? Now, if you wanted to, of course, you could put a bit of grilled fish or something on the side. As you know, I don't say we have to eat all raw, but predominantly raw. He's back into it. Probably already eaten. It's enough crunch and it's satisfying.
What are those beans?
Mung beans? No.
They're lima, the white ones?
They're yum.
Okay, they're the kidney beans, the red ones. Okay, now we're going to try the dessert. I did get a sneak taste of it. Okay. And it goes well with that. Because after eating something that's really sort of healthy, if you went and had like a really sweet pudding, they don't kind of go together because your mouth's nice and fresh after eating the raw foods. Yeah. So that goes with it. Andrew?
Yes.
You try that one.
What is this?
This is going to surprise the hell out of you. Well, that's
orange and almond. It's completely raw, so it's almond meal, psyllium husk, which sort of gelatinizes it. And,
surprising.
Orange.
Very tasty, it's not too sweet, but sweet, still sweet.
Yeah, but it goes well with a salad. Whereas, you know, when you have something that's like those fast food places, that sort of would go off because you feel like something sweet and, you know, that goes with the grease. Whereas that and that blend well together. So, Simon, thank you very much. We're going to get you on the program again, actually, because he's passed. Well, guys, that's it from us. So it seems that the Little Green Cafe has passed the test. They sure have. So don't be frightened to either ring ahead or go in and ask what you want. Just because it says it's on the menu, it's up to you what you want. If we don't ask for the right things, how are we ever going to get them? Catch you soon.